Hey everyone, and welcome back. So today we'll be covering the recap of E3 2021 for day 4 for the Nintendo Switch, which is pretty much the Nintendo Direct. Now since this is the final and probably biggest day for the Nintendo Switch, we'll be doing it a little different than the other days. I'll start with the normal rapid-fire recap of everything we saw in the Nintendo Direct. However, at the end, I'll be taking the time to reflect on what I personally thought of the Nintendo Direct as well. So for all of you that are only here for the recap, well, basically you can watch through the first part of the video and skip out on the commentary after. For those of you, however, that maybe saw the Direct and are more here for the commentary and my reaction to it, well, you can skip over the recap and go directly to the commentary. I'll be basically marking it in the video down below. So now, without further ado, let's get started on the recap. And just before, remember that if you do like this content, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you aren't already. Now, in my opinion, the Nintendo Direct started out with a bang with the reveal of a new Smash Brothers character in Kazuya Mishima from the Tekken series. Personally, I am super excited about this character being added. I'm a fan of Tekken, although not a diehard one. I still have been playing since the original release on the PS1, and you know what? Kazuya was one of my main characters, so I am super excited about this announcement. Next, we had the announcement of Life is Strange, both True Colors and the remastered collection that are coming to the Switch. True Colors, we have a release date for September 10th, and the remastered collection, however, is just going to be later this year. We didn't get a specific release date. Now, this is basically an interactive series. It looks beautiful from the presentation we saw here, and I know a bunch of people are going to be excited for this. I personally, not super into this series, but nonetheless, it does look beautiful. Now next, we got the announcement that Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy is coming to the Switch on October 26th. However, if you had noticed, they did mention that this will be a cloud-based game. It was written very small in one of the corners. So what that means is basically your mileage will vary. It'll depend on your internet connection and also the servers they set up for to support the game. I can't wait to find out if this is going to be a good experience or not. Next, we got a reminder that Worms Rumble is going to be releasing on June 23rd, which is basically the Worms series in a Battle Royale online version. This game does interest me. I most likely will be checking it out. Keep your eyes peeled for that one. Next, we got the announcement of a new JRPG coming to the Switch, which is Astria Ascending. Now, honestly, we didn't get very much information on this game, so we'll have to wait probably further down the road till it gets fleshed out to see what this game is actually more about. Next came a game that we saw in two other presentations, which was Two Point Campus, and it was a confirmation that it was coming to the Switch, something we pretty much already knew. I was really hoping for Nintendo to surprise us and give an actual release date for the game. Unfortunately, it was just confirmed to be coming out later this year. Next came a surprise release, and by the presentation, a lot of people thought it was going to be a Donkey Kong Country game, but no, it was a Super Monkey Ball game in the form of Banana Mania that we'll be getting on October 5th. Now, this is a remaster of some of the original Super Monkey Balls. I personally am super hyped for this game. I'm a fan of Super Monkey Ball. Next, we got the announcement of a new Mario Party coming for October 29th in the form of Mario Party Superstars, which is pretty much a combination of all the most popular minigames from the previous Mario Parties. What was really interesting is Nintendo took the time to really mention that all the games were going to be available online. This could turn out to be quite a good release for fans of Mario Party. Next came my top announcement of the whole presentation and probably one of the most surprising announcements in the form of Metroid 5 Dread. Yes, we are not getting a new Metroid Prime, we are getting a new 2D Metroid. And I am super hyped for this game, especially that it got a specific release date of October 8th. Now, we're going to be talking more about this in my commentary later on, so I don't want to go too deep into this, but you know what? Metroid Dread is going to be a top game for me this holiday season. Then, Nintendo just reconfirmed Just Dance 2022, coming out on November 4th. Yoo-hoo, we all knew it was coming already, we saw it in the Ubisoft presentation. Next, they did a spotlight on Cruisin' Blast, which is a over-the-top arcade racer coming to the Switch. Once again, don't know what to think about this series, don't have any reference points, we'll see when it releases. Next, we had the confirmation that Dragon Ball Z Kakarot was coming to the Nintendo Switch on September 24th. A lot of people are looking forward to this release. I personally am a super big fan of Dragon Ball. However, I've played through the main storyline many, many times already. I'm not sure I'm going to do it another time in this game. I'll see how the release turns out. Then we got a really extended look at Mario Golf that is coming out on June 25th. And I'm really glad that they're giving these extended looks because I personally, when they announced Mario Golf, was really lukewarm on that release. Normally in the sports Mario franchises, the golf series is not one that gets me excited. However, this entry really looks like something I'm going to want to play. So I do think that finally I am going to be picking up Mario Golf on June 25th. Next, we had Monster Hunter Stories 2, and we finally got a look at some gameplay, and it looks quite fantastic. So good news for anyone who's a fan of the franchise, looks like the game is in pretty good shape. Next, we got another surprise release that a lot of people were looking forward to. We got the announcement of a new WarriorWare coming to the Switch on September 10th. Can't wait to pick this one up. Another exciting release from Nintendo. Finally, to the amazement of a lot of people, we finally got a release date on Shin Megami Tensei 5 that is going to be coming out on November 12th. I could not believe that we're finally getting a release date 4 years after the announcement for this game. JRPG fans are going to be super excited for this one. Not sure I'm going to have the time to play this one through because normally Shin Megami Tenseis are quite a few hours of investment. Next came a series that I actually personally am not too familiar with, Danganronpa. However, from the reactions online, I do think this game does have a pretty strong cult following. On top of it, there seems to be one of the games that seems like almost like a Mario Party-like game. So I'm pretty sure that this one is going to be another one I'm going to check out just to become familiar with the series. Now next, we got an announcement for a series that a lot of people were looking forward to the next one, and that is Fatal Frame Maiden of Black Water. Unfortunately, we didn't get a specific release date on this one. We only got an announcement for later this year. Next, what would a Nintendo Direct be without a few shadow drops? And we got the first one of those in the expansion packs for the Doom Eternal game. Now this game is right now 50% off on the eShop. Perfect time to pick it up if you wanted to try out the DLC at the same time. Also got an announcement that the remakes of Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 and 2 will be coming to the Nintendo Switch on June 25th. That's only a couple of weeks away. I am super hyped for this one. The remakes look amazing. Next, we got the second and last shadow drop of the day in the form of Strange Brigade, which seems like a 3D action game, sort of along the lines of, I would say, a Tomb Raider. Don't know what to think about this game, but I'll be definitely checking out reviews or trying it for myself. Next, Nintendo covered the release of Mario + Rabbids Sparks of Hope. Once again, I'm super hyped for this game. Only disappointing part, it's announced for 2022 without even a mention if it's early or late 2022. I personally think this game is quite a whiles away, but I'm still super hyped for this next release. The only thing, we already knew about it once again from the Ubisoft announcement. Next, we got another top announcement for me from this Direct, which is the announcement of the remakes of Advance Wars 1+2 coming to the Nintendo Switch on December 3rd. Look, I've already pre-ordered my copy of this game. I love Advance Wars. The remakes look great. I cannot wait to play these games on my Nintendo Switch. Next, we got to the Zelda part of the presentation, and the first thing we heard about are expansion packs coming to Hyrule Warriors, with the first set coming out on June 18th, and the second set that is announced for sometime in November. Now, a lot of people loved Hyrule Warriors, and they'll be super excited to be able to dive back in with some new content. Now, next, we got another quick look at Skyward Sword, and a reminder that it's coming out very, very soon in July. Pretty much everyone already knows about this game if you're a Zelda fan. So once again, it was fun to see, but it wasn't news once again. Now next, we got the announcement of a new Game & Watch. Now I saw this one coming a mile away, but it is a Zelda-themed Game & Watch. We're going to get three games on it, Zelda 1, Zelda 2, and Zelda Link's Awakening, the Game Boy version. I personally going to be picking this one up. It is releasing on November 12th. Finally, Nintendo closed out the presentation with the moment everyone was waiting for, but unfortunately, a lot of people will be disappointed once again. We did not get much more information about Breath of the Wild 2 other than a slight gameplay trailer. Now, if you are seriously into Breath of the Wild, I recommend you check out the whole trailer for this part of the presentation. But then again, we didn't get as much information as people were hoping for, other than the fact that finally they announced it is supposed to be releasing in 2022. Once again, no details though of beginning or end of 2022. I'm thinking holiday release next year. That was pretty much it for our recap of the Nintendo Direct and pretty much the recap of day 4 for the Nintendo Switch. Now I'm going to be moving on to my commentary on what I personally thought of the Direct and the things that I'm most looking forward to and maybe a couple of the things that disappointed me. Now first of all, yesterday I asked you all to give a letter grade to the actual Nintendo Direct presentation and we got quite a few people that actually voted. And I'm glad to see that your vision of the Nintendo Direct was somewhat along my vision as well, with most people grading it between an A to C grade. And I would say that almost half of you actually agreed with the exact letter grade I personally would have given it. I would have given this presentation a B as well. To me, this was clearly not an A presentation. There were missing maybe one or two really big announcements to make this an A presentation. I was really debating between B and C, but you know what? They did surprise us with at least two games that a lot of people were looking forward to, and I think they deserve credit for that, which is why I'm giving this a B. Now, if you know me and you follow the channel, you know I'm a super huge fan of 2D platformers, and specifically also the Metroidvania subgenre. And you know what? That is why I am super hyped, and my really top announcement of this is the 2D Metroid coming to us in the form of Metroid Dread. Honestly, I'm actually more excited about this than a Metroid Prime 4. I know this isn't going to be the situation for everyone, but I personally am super hyped about this announcement. I am definitely going to be picking up this game day one and most likely even streaming it the day it releases. Also, the fact that they're doing a suspenseful horror twist on this seemed to be pursued by an enemy that you actually can't challenge and can't deal with till probably, I'm guessing, the end of the game. It looks like an awesome twist on the original franchise. Now moving on, the second point that really got me super excited is the remasters of Advanced Wars. I'm actually wondering why it took so long to get the Advanced Wars series on the Nintendo Switch. That's the only sort of thing that I'm baffled about, is that this should have been a no-brainer and should have been done within the first 2 years of the Switch's life. But you know what? Rather than focusing on that, I'm just focusing on the fact that we're finally getting full remasters for the first two games. And honestly, I'm just really hoping that they're going to be putting a little extra content in there to really spice it up and give it something new for long-standing fans of the series. Now, next on my list of positive things was the announcement of the Game & Watch. Now, I said it when I was going through the recap, I saw this coming a mile away. With the success they got from the Mario Brothers one, it was definite that they were going to do it again. And I think that this one will sell like hotcakes, especially because they included Link's Awakening. The fact that they included the Game Boy version of Link's Awakening, I think is going to change it for pretty much everyone that was looking at this Game & Watch. And if you were on the fence, all of a sudden you jumped over the fence and you're picking this one up. And I would say the last two announcements I do want to mention, because I think it's going to be strong points for a lot of people. Number one, WarioWare. A lot of people are going to be super happy that we're getting a new WarioWare. And also, the fact that we're getting a new Mario Party that looks like it's going to be a lot stronger version of the game than the one we already got, and the fact that they're specifying that it's going to be playable online, I think is going to be a top announcement for a lot of people. I also wanted to mention, maybe on a lesser note, that there's also the announcement of the remake of the Super Monkey Ball franchise. Now, if you watch once again regularly, you know I am a fan of Sega as well, and Super Monkey Ball is a franchise I love. I'm glad we're getting remakes of two of the originals. Now, let's talk about a couple of disappointing points, and let's address the elephant in the room. Number one, yes, I am super disappointed that Breath of the Wild isn't getting a specific release date, and even more so that it's not this year. But I'm a realistic guy, and I knew that wasn't going to happen this year. With Skyward Sword coming out this year, even with Zelda's anniversary, and the fact that just earlier they said that they weren't ready to present anything before now, you know what? It was guaranteed that that game was not going to be far along enough to be finished by the end of the year. If you know Nintendo, they're not going to botch a release just to release it quicker. They're going to do the extra work and make sure that when they release it, it's a smash hit. And you know what? I'm okay with waiting another year if we get an extremely polished and extremely well-designed game. Number two, the second elephant for most people will be the hardware issue. But once again, I was realistic. I was pretty sure we weren't going to get it. Number one, Nintendo said it was a software-only presentation. Now, they could have lied, but there was no reason to do so. And since this is not a brand new console, but rather a refresh type of situation, I'm telling you right now, if they announce it, it won't be more than a month to a month and a half before the actual release of the console. If you think of it from a business perspective, if they announce a refresh, no one's buying the old version of the console. They're not going to do that 2 to 3 months ahead of time. If we are getting a refresh closer to the holiday season, between September and December, we are only going to hear about it at the very end of the summer, I guarantee you. But you know what? I'm not psychic. Maybe we won't even hear about any refresh this year, but I am still hopeful that we're going to get one before the end of the year, even though they didn't present it here, probably because production isn't ready. Now, more on the realistic front, in the sense that those were the two elephants in the room, but I was pretty sure they weren't going to happen. I was still really hoping for a Zelda collection. I was hoping for the announcement of a Zelda collection for the holiday season. But you know what? If you look at their calendar, there are a few big releases in October or December, but there seems to be missing that one last big punch out that Nintendo is used to. Maybe at the same time as we get that hardware refresh announcement at the end of the summer, they are going to amaze us all with a limited release of a Zelda collection, just like they did for Mario. And the second point that I was hoping for more realistically, and that I'm disappointed we didn't get, was an addition to the online service. I was really hoping for either some of the Game Boy libraries, Nintendo 64 libraries, or at least announcements that we were going in that direction. Unfortunately, we didn't get it here, so yes, I was disappointed for those points. But overall, the reason I'm giving this a B is that in the end, I came out with a hyped feeling for at least 2 to 3 games. And you know what? That is more than any other presentation this year. I mean, yes, some of the indie presentations did interest me game-wise, but I wasn't as hyped as I was about these announcements. You know what? That is pretty much it for my thoughts on the E3 Nintendo Direct. Now, I want to hear from all of you. What did you think about the Direct? Let me know in the comments down below. Now, as usual, I do want to thank the supporters of the channel. Just to let you know, memberships are now open. You can check that out down below in the description of the video. Also, very exceptionally, probably this week, eShop deals under $5 is going to be delayed till tomorrow, so Thursday rather than Wednesday, just because I'm a little overworked with all of the E3 stuff, but I really wanted to wrap it up first. And just on the way out, don't forget that if you did like this content, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, hit that notification bell so you know when all my future content comes out, and as usual, I hope I'll see you in my next video.